This is Face the State with Dennis House, Connecticut's most watched local political program.
Good morning and happy Mother's Day to all of you out there. All of our guests today are not only politicians, they are mothers. First, even though there were no big debates over taxes or guns this legislative session, there were still some hot button issues on the table and some new laws were passed that will impact each and every one of us. And with us today to talk about this, two state representatives. First, Democrat Michelle Cook of Torrington and Republican Melissa Gebran of East Hadaman. And Representative Gebran, what do you think was the biggest accomplishment this session? Do you agree?
I think there was a lot of different accomplishments. I don't know if I can put my hand on any one large accomplishment. We did a lot of things for manufacturers with tax credits and helping out small businesses. But frankly, there were a lot of things that we did to harm them as well.
You know, and everyone's asking, are my taxes going up?
Yes.
They are. Okay, answer for us, please.
I mean, you know, there's technically, there's claiming no tax increases in the budget, but there's a lot of spending. I mean, the budget is 2% growth. When you compound that with the governor's first term in office, we have additional over $4 billion in spending over those tax increases. One of the most strangest things we saw for me on the last day was an excuse of the sales tax for the Excel Center and another auditorium-like facility in the southern part of the state, which is a revenue loss. So, you know, it was some strange things that happened on that last day, for sure.
The New London Day was critical of the spending increase
right.
This year, saying it's just not sustainable.
This year, the Republicans did offer an alternative budget. We were very proud of the fact that our budget proposal did not increase the out years. This budget that we passed does that and more. We don't pay pension. That's over $50 million. They did take out Keno, but we're relying on a $75 million mystery tax revenue gain where we're saying we're going to collect taxes from those who haven't paid. And so, you know, it's very troubling. I think the foundation is troubling.
You know, Republicans don't have the numbers to stop the Democrats' plan, which is why it's important for your party in the fall to make an argument that more Republicans should be elected. What will you be telling people this fall?
Well, this fall, I'll be talking about, you know, stop kicking the can down the road, stop kicking that bucket, and really face up to some hard truths, which is we're spending money we don't have. We're making a business climate that is really not attractive for businesses. We passed a law this year that says that you can, as a potential employee, you know, make a complaint to the Department of Labor if you feel you've been turned down for a job because of your unemployment status. I mean, we are looking at large things, really a lot of onerous things on our business community. And, you know, the polling is saying 50% of people want to leave the state of Connecticut. We're trying to make it better. And I think to do that, you got to start telling the truth.
Representatively, half of people in our state are unhappy and want to leave. How did that impact lawmakers at the Capitol?
Well, for us, you know, as I was fortunate as a freshman to be involved in the budget process on the Republican side. So we really did sharpen our pencils and make some very difficult decisions in our alternative budget. So when that news came out, we were right back at the drawing table, saying, you know, if we proposed a budget, we have to be fair now and propose a budget based on these new revenue projections. And so we did that. We started really having some very difficult conversations about what it would look like. But as my leader, Representative Cafaro, has said, you know, we have built a house based on a foundation that we didn't build. We're taking the Democrats' foundation and trying to mold around it. But, you know, I think we were willing to do that. The Democrats, you know, did the same, but their outlook is much different than ours.
A lot of lawmakers spent a lot of time in the past couple of days praising some folks who were leaving. And one, I believe Senator Meyer got 2 hours worth of praise in the Capitol. And yet last night, Wednesday night, when the session was ending, they were saying that there wasn't enough time to vote on some bills. What do you think of that? And I'll begin with you, Representative Gebran. Was the time wasted when it should have been working for the taxpayers?
It wasn't. We didn't use our time wisely. I don't know if I'd use the term wasted, but we certainly didn't use our time wisely. I had a lot of folks lobbying me on certain bills, and what I kept reminding them is, we've been in session now. Yes, the last week has been almost every day, but frankly, if the Democrats wanted that to be a priority, they could have passed it 3 weeks ago. So when we're starting to run the clock out, We certainly have the ability as Republicans to ask questions and talk about bills and negotiate for priorities. But the bottom line is the Democrats have full majority in every level. If they want that bill, they can pass it. I don't think we spend our time wisely, though, for sure.
Let's talk about the eels briefly. What exactly was the eel issue?
It's glass eels right now. There's no regulations at all around them. And so what's happening is you have a lot of people out there now, taking them as a totally against the law. By starting with some regulation, the hope is that we're going to be able to really drive and get away from the illegal activity that's happening if you allow a very small window. It's interesting to me how that's become the highlight here, but I happen to enjoy sushi myself, although I don't eat anything with eels in it. That's my son. He loves that, but that was the issue. And I understand the other side's argument. There was some people that were concerned about the environmental impact of that.
And you're both running for